MMAViking.com here with Nico Musoke here at Rink of the Muay Thai. Nico, let's first talk about you coming to Stockholm. The UFC's kind of shipped you around the world. You've been to Brazil, you were in Texas, you had a short fight in the UK. What does it feel like to come back and fight here in Stockholm?
It's awesome. I've been blessed with the opportunity to travel the world in this short time. And now they're coming to Stockholm, my hometown. It's another dream come true. Happy, looking forward to it.
Did you have a personal talk with Dana saying, hey Dana, let's put me close to home, we know this card's coming up, or how did you actually get put on this card?
No, they approached me, asked me that they were looking for me to fight on that card. If we rewind, I haven't been shy to say that, of course. I want to be on any card when the UFC comes to Stockholm. So, yeah, they approached me, I said yes, and we're good to go.
How is it different for you now? I mean, you're kind of like the young prospect that no one really knew that much about, and now, I mean, there's a lot of tape that you've won submission of the night and been a co-headliner.
Yeah.
How is it different coming into your fourth fight now? How has that changed for you?
It's different in the sense that, okay, I'm more used to, say, the build-up before the fight. Everything is much bigger, the tension is bigger, but then again, we're there to fight, and it's in its core, it's the same thing. Doesn't matter if it's here in Stockholm, in Brazil, in a small arena in Finland, as it was back in the days when you were out there following me. You're going to fight, and that's something you also need to remind yourself that, okay, all in all, enjoy everything that comes with the bigger shows, but be ready when it's time.
Let's talk about your training a bit. I mean, we're interviewing you today at Rink of the Muay Thai.
Yeah, you get to see Rink of the Muay Thai, huh?
Yeah, it's been really fascinating learning a bit about the history here and getting to the gyms that aren't these more super MMA gyms. Can you talk about your training now and the different places that you're kind of picking up techniques and how you're putting together this camp?
Yeah, like today we're here in Rinkeby Muay Thai, training with Sasha Martinovic. I spend many days a week here under his watchful eye, soaking up as much as possible. And we've been working together since before the last fight. Things have been going good. As well, I'm training at Prana Jiu-Jitsu, Surbrunnsgatan, with Kenta. Working, wrestling, jiu-jitsuing with the beasts over there. And also, I do my wrestling at BK10, where we have, Swedish champions, Olympians, world champions, European champions. And all in all, they are in sync with each other. They talk with each other. A plan was set quite a few weeks back. Everything will unfold October 4th.
Yeah, you seem to be kind of confident thinking about this fight. You know, you're a confident guy in general, but maybe let's talk about this matchup with Alexander Yakovlev. How do you see you guys matching up?
He's a tall guy. So am I for the weight class. He fights southpaw, meaning he leads with his right hand. He seems well-versed. When it comes to, no major, well-rounded. He knows how to follow a game plan and seems very schooled in fighting. That's what I know about him.
And you've seemed very schooled in fighting. I think people have asked me about your style, and it's really hard to pinpoint. I mean, you've showed wrestling, your first UFC debut with a submission. How would you describe your fighting style and mentality for people that haven't seen you?
It's kind of tricky. I mean, if you ask me, you should always seek to raise the bar for, like, you can't have any major gaps when it comes to MMA. You'll be called on that. And that's what I seek to do all the time. Raising the bar for every fight, in between every fight, watching it as a whole. With that said, of course, you have your own tendencies and things you do better. And sure, time should be put into honing those skills as well. But all in all, you need to see kind of the whole circle expand.
We were talking before this fight, you were joking you could walk to the event, which I guess you probably could.
Like, yeah, it'd be a walk.
Like 20 minutes, half hour?
Yeah, something like that. Okay. A bit more, maybe.
What is it, what's it like fighting so close to home, and what type of support do you think you'll have at the event?
It's always special to be able to fight at home. And this time, probably in the most famous, the biggest indoor arena that, this far has hosted an MMA event. It's gonna be epic. I've been there for the previous shows, seen them. It has been magical in many ways. And we're out there, and this time we'll do everything to top those previous experiences. It's gonna be epic. I hope and expect a full house, nothing less. We have this term in Swedish, it's called folkfest. I don't know if there's a direct translation to English, but this is more than just an event. This is a movement, and I hope people show up to show that we're here to stay. For good.
Great. Well, we look forward to the fight just 2.5 weeks from now. Get to see a true folk fest here in Stockholm. And thanks for your time, Nico.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for covering. Thank you for coming out. As always, appreciate it. And see you guys October 4th.